Yo, yo, yo.
Yo, we here with our man, Articulate. Yo, man, how's it going? Thank you so much for taking the time.
Yo, it's great. Super excited to be here. I'm trying to contain it all in so I don't go all nuts.
Yeah. He's like,
thanks for having us, bro. I mean,
thanks for my space boots. So excited.
thanks for being a part of the whole movement here. And man, we're just really excited to have you.
Yeah, man. No, it's a dope organization. You guys got a dope mission. It's a blessing to be a part of it, honestly.
Thank you so much, man. Thank you so much.
That means a lot, man. Well, for those of people who are watching, might not know who you are, give us a lowdown. Who's Articulate? What are you all about? How would you best describe yourself to someone who has never heard your music before, heard you perform before?
Oh, man. So my name is Robert. My poetry name, I go by Articulate. I'm a spoken word artist from Pomona. That name came from a friend of mine in high school who just, when I was just starting out with poetry, I was sharing some of my stuff, and she's just like, yo, this is really articulate. And I thought, wow, that has a good ring to it. I think I'm going to keep it, but you know, I got to switch it up a little bit, make it my own. So I took the A out of the first A out of articulate and just kept it R, you know, because my first name starts with an R, and then did that. So that's how that name came about.
Nice.
And man, what I'm about, that's crazy. I mean, I do a lot of different things. Right now I just got a new job. I work for this church. So I've been working with the youth over here, and that's been crazy because of COVID, the pandemic, and then learning to adapt and everything. And I've never done anything like that before. And so there's just been a lot of, pressure making diamond moments throughout the year. When I'm not doing that, I try to be really into my writing. I'm a bit of a lazy writer, but whenever I get to come to a space like this, or I get to see some of the people you guys had on your stage, like Judah, Super B,
yeah,
I get super inspired, and I felt, I've got to go write something now.
Yeah. That fool was flexing the whole time. Remember? That fool was amazing. But yeah, man. Pomona has an amazing community. Tell us more about Pomona and the whole community. Like, everybody got to know, man. In the world out there, whenever you come to California, you'll stop by Pomona. It's like the last city of Los Angeles County. It's right on the border, right at the end. Like, people consider it 909, but it's really Los Angeles County, but it's the very end. And, I know everybody likes Hollywood and everybody likes Silver Lake and shit. But Pomona has some deep art. And really great painters, musicians, poetry, especially dancers. It's a really nice area. But are you from Pomona?
Yeah, I'm from Pomona. It's crazy because I did not start. So I'm 30 years old, and I did not start knowing about the artistic roots and the atmosphere of Pomona until I was about. Maybe like 21. So I lived in Pomona from about 1 to 15, lived in Chino for a few years, and then came back. And then I started hearing about places like A Mic and Dim Lights, and then just different names. Some of y'all have passed around in these podcasts, Best Kept, Super B, Judah.
Yeah.
And then from there, I started finding out about other spots. There's they have one at a spot there called Cafe Con Libros. Mm-hmm. And that one was going about, I think, once a month on a Friday or a Saturday, and then had to stop because of the pandemic. But now it's picked up again by a guy named Cesar Kevlar called Obsidian Tongues. And I'm going into the stuff right now, but I think one of the things that hit me, that let me know Pomona was just such a great spot for artists, and particularly for poetry, was I got to meet a poet by the name of Rudy Francisco that might be familiar with some of you, some of you maybe not.
Back in the day, real quick, I used to perform at Cupsy when I was going to USF, and Teresa Saikatonu, who was one of my mentors, really close with him, and they had like a lot of stuff that they did out there, and... Man, what's the one on Fairfax again? Why am I blanking? I don't remember the name of the slam that's on Fairfax in LA.
Is that Limelight?
No. Oh, man, I don't remember the name. Anyway, I remember, but he's awesome. He's got, like, the best love poems.
I feel like he's become the most popular. Like, even people who I did not know were into poetry at all could quote a Rudy Francisco. Yeah. And so, you know, when I met him and I told him where I was from, and he goes, oh, man, how's the mic and dim lights? Like, I used to come over there. I knew all the people. That's where I got started. I was like, what? Yeah. I did not know this. He goes, yeah, man. And I started finding out all these other bigger poetry names were coming there regularly at some point. And I thought, wow, what have I been missing out on my whole life?
Man. Yo, you know, go ahead, Vic. I'm sorry to cut you up here. No, my bad. Go ahead, gorgeous. Go ahead.
That's it. It's just special, man. It's a special place because there's not many slabs out in that area, you know?
Mm-hmm. It's just grown. It's grown. It's so crazy.
It's awesome. Big shit going on in P-Town.
Mm-hmm.
That's how we do it. We keep it moving. But Pat, yo, man, what's going on there now? Like, I haven't been to Pomona since the pandemic, but did they set up like block out the streets and outdoor vending and stuff like that during the pandemic? How was it?
Yeah. You know, especially the art walk, a lot of the restaurants started setting up their outdoor stuff and everything. And then I started seeing, just some people taking their acts outdoor. There's a group called Pomona Loud. They're very young. They just started a few years ago, and they were one of the first Pomona organizations to start putting out for artists again. And so they started having an open mic a couple months ago. I forget the area, but it's near the art walk. And so people were coming out there in their masks and everything, keeping distance and whatnot. And then they provided like mics, speakers, they have vendors. Like, it was a whole thing, and I was really just it makes you proud to be from here, see everybody be so innovative and just so entrepreneurial.
And then the crazy thing about Pomona is very, you know, like it's very humble, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. For people to try to do so much with so little resources that they have is amazing. And it goes to show you that, you know, you know, Shot in the Dark has so many meanings, you know what I mean? You know what mm-hmm. I mean? And like, you know, to be able to have like people like you guys coming in that, you know, doing what you do, and then everybody gets a shot in the dark. Everybody gets a shot in the dark. Like, even if you don't have much, like, you have a shot in the dark. It's that easy, yo. Go to one of these gigs, go to Pomona, or jump on one of these, you know, shows. But you can be right there. I mean, I've seen it happen where people come from humble beginnings, and all they do is they're in the right place at the right time, and they're really passionate about what they do. And someone sees something, and you create relationships, and before you know, you have a long time friend or whatever. You know what I mean? But and then you have an opportunity to unlock your art that you might not even knew that you had inside of you. You know what I mean? It's an amazing thing, you know. And it all starts from somewhere. No one's born with like all kinds of singing ability, and like everybody thinks like, oh, I can't do that. Just be a part of it. Even if you're just not even a singer, like, you can be a helper, you know what I mean? You could be an organizer, you know what I mean? There's so many things that you could be a part of, you know, and we need more of that, you know what I mean? We need more people to want to be down with the culture, because everybody wants to go. I mean, you know, every once in a while you go to a club, but there's a lot of those already. There's not enough of like organizations of like cool places where you could take your whole family, or not even that, or just learn something. Instead of just get drunk, you know what I mean?
Right.
You know what I mean?
That's what I mean. And you know what? It's a great point. There was one of the times at a Mic and Dim Lights during the anniversary a few years ago. I forget her name. It was Kat. I don't remember the full name, but she was one of the legends over there. And she had spat a poem about, I think it was just like open mic etiquette 101, something like that. And one of the lines was like, for those of you who sign up and, you know, don't get to come in, maybe it wasn't your turn to perform, but it was your turn to listen. It was your turn to be educated. And I think that's very downplayed. A lot of times we come to these spaces thinking, I'm only coming if I could show myself.
Right.
Yo, there's just so much to soak in, even if you're not, you know, the one on stage that needs to get highlighted a little bit more.
Exactly. Exactly. And then that's the love part. That's about giving love. Like, you know, especially, you know, when you're in those kind of spaces, when you see all the nationalities and all the people giving each other love in the same circle, like it's contagious. And mm-hmm. you need to, and more people that are outside of that little, that don't feel comfortable need to come in and witness that. And they'll start to see life a little bit different. And that's like, you kind of like it infects them. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. A little bit. You know what I mean? I feel, you know what I mean? You know, yeah. and then there's a gap, you know, before you go into your everyday like life and shit and people transform into like the workforce, you know?
Yeah.
But when you're like, you know, impressionable from like, you know, your 18 college years and stuff like that, this is important education mm-hmm. for everybody. I think just to know how to interact with different people. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. That like the same thing. You know what I mean? You know what I mean?
The community, you know what I mean? Develop the community of like-minded folks who are doing similar stuff, you know?
Exactly, yeah. Man. And you can see how much things that people can do with so little resources just because they want to do it. And these things are, that's one thing that you know, Vic, because you work with a lot of organizations. These things don't get done because like the government's going to do it. Like it's people that actually have to go over there and sign the petitions and get the things moving to make these things happen. It doesn't just go like, oh, yo, make a wish list and then they'll make it happen for you. Like that doesn't work that way. It takes someone to make an initiative to make it happen. You know what I mean? Yeah. And things that people think that might not ever happen end up happening because someone tried, you know? Right. And that's what I love about Pomona, man. They do so many different things. Man, I went to my first rave and one of my first raves in Pomona. Like, you know what I mean? I was like 16 years old. Like, dude, I've seen some crazy things in Pomona. You know what I mean? Let's put it that way. Pomona is like definitely stomping grounds for me. Yo, like,
there's so many different, you know, you have the college, right? You have the folks who have lived there for so long. You have the arts people just from like, you know, Old Town Pomona or whatever it's called now. The arts area, right? So it's definitely a cool melting pot. So for anyone, I mean, we've had a lot of artists that we've showcased from Pomona here, but from anyone who hasn't spent some time out there, I mean, there's the Fox, you know, there's the Glass House, there's the record store, there's antique shops, there's you know, all this stuff out there. So you all definitely gotta go check it out. Mm-hmm. Tell me about the performance you did on Shot in the Dark. Tell me about present.
What they're going to watch right now. Let them know what they're going to watch right now.
So present. Oh, man. So it's funny. I think at the time I had I wrote that during the pandemic. So it's really, really new, just last year. I had gone through a dry spell in writing. You know, I had a big writer's block. And so at the time I was involved with this lady, and we didn't know what we were doing. We're definitely not just friends, but we're not anything official. So we're trying to figure things out. And one of the things that really drew us to one another was that we felt like we were, you know, like the poem says, we were present for one another. Like she was seeing all of me, I was seeing all of her. It wasn't just about us having fun, but it was us, in fact, being present, being raw, being vulnerable, keeping 100 all the time, no matter how vulnerable it might have made us. Right. And so, you know, I'm carrying all those feelings. And then Judah One had started an Instagram live podcast-ish type of thing called Poet to Poet. I think that's what it was called. And I think he was trying to do it every Monday. And so it was him and Super B. They were talking, and I don't know what it was. It was a creative spirit or something, but in the midst of listening to these two, I had a writing itch. I had a writing itch, and it just would not leave. I remember staying up that night, and I started playing around with different words, and then that first line came in, you know, what a present it is to be present within her presence. Mm. And it just, the rest just kind of took off. And along with that, there's such a theme in there about progression, and that was us going from, you know, a lot of that was a metaphor for how we were just friends, but in the midst of a friendship, we, you know, we unawarely just got closer to one another, and it turned into something deeper. And you see that there's just a big theme of journey in there.
Man, that's amazing, man. Especially, I mean, I've been there and being in like a writer's funk and just like not being able to find the thing that kind of gets you you know, you're looking at a blank page and it's so daunting, right? And you're just like, fuck, no matter what I put here, none of it's sticking. Man, that's powerful. That's amazing. Yo, but we want to make sure that people get a chance to watch it and that they get a chance to check it out. So before we jump and go straight into that video, where can people find you online? What's coming down the pipeline? You know, what should people expect for you coming through pretty soon?
Man, it's going through the shutdown and everything, I've had a lot of time to try different things. And so I have a bunch of ideas in my head, but nothing's been fully like set in stone yet. But to keep up with me, I am on Instagram. You can find me at legendary_heartthrobrob. I made it that obnoxious so that nobody would ever forget it. They know it's me when you look for it. And then I have, I got one video on there, another recent one, a poem called Bigger Dreams, which again, you know, happened during the pandemic, which was crazy for me because during the pandemic, felt like everything got smaller and I felt like I had to start dreaming bigger. And then that came about. And so that's like one of my more recent bigger projects we've been trying to spread out. And then from there, I'm just trying to see where I could take my talents to, not necessarily to serve me, but to serve my community, to serve everybody around me. I aim to be able to write stuff, to get people to, I want to be able to write stuff that allows people to say, hey, that's how I feel, and I just didn't know how to say it. Mm. So, you know, this poem was like, your poem was my outlet to be able to express myself. So thank you.
Yeah, absolutely, man. I mean, finding the right words to articulate that feeling sometimes doesn't come as easy.
Yes.
Awesome. Mm. Yo, well, once again, thank you so much for taking the time and talking with us. We're super excited to see what else you got coming down the pipeline, all these big ideas coming to fruition, manifesting themselves. But keep us posted. Let us know how we can support you. Everyone watching, be sure to give this guy a follow. Keep on keeping on with what this guy's got going on. But until then, be sure to stay on tune. We got Present coming up right now.
Yo, heartthrob. Yo, make sure you come down to the mixer. We're gonna have this end of the month, right? So.
Shoot me the info. I'd definitely love to be there at that.
Okay, so yeah, man. All right, heartthrob. I'll talk to you later, big dog.
Awesome. Thank you so much again.
Thank you, guys.
You stay, bro.